واستمع يوم ينادي المنادي من مكان قريب يوم يسمعون الصيحة. The day they will hear the blast. On the day when the trumpet will be blown, they will hear the blast. How will they hear it? بالحق, with the truth. What does it mean by بالحق? Meaning باليقين. They will hear it and they will be certain that what they have heard is in fact the call to Hashr. Before that they were in doubt, but when they will hear the blowing of the trumpet, they will know for sure exactly what it is. Who will? All the people. ذَلِكَ يَوْمُ الْخُرُوجِ. That is the day of emergence. That is the day of exit. That is the day of coming out. Coming out from where? From the graves. That is the day when everyone will come out of their graves alive. In Surah Yasin, Ayah 51, we learn, وَنُفِخَ فِي الصُّورِ فَإِذَا هُمْ مِنَ الْأَجْدَاثِ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَنْسِلُونَ. And the horn will be blown, and at once from the graves to their Lord, they will hasten. In Surah Al-Qamar, Ayah 7-8, خُشَّعَنْ أَبُصَارُهُمْ يَخْرُجُونَ مِنَ الْأَجْدَاثِ كَأَنَّهُمْ جَرَادٌ مُنْتَشِرٌ مُهْطِعِينَ إِلَى الدَّاعِي. That as people will rise from their graves, their eyes humbled, they will emerge from the graves as if they were locusts. Locusts spreading everywhere. Meaning thousands and thousands, millions and millions of people. Imagine from the first to the last, as if they are locusts spreading everywhere. And they'll be racing ahead toward the caller, toward where the sound is coming from. إِنَّا نَحْنُ نُحْيِي وَنُمِيتُ. Indeed, it is we who give life and cause death. Allah is the one who causes life. He is the one who gives life to people on this earth. And He is the one who causes death to them as well, when their lives come to an end. وَإِلَيْنَا الْمَصِيرُ. And when He causes death, then what happens? To us is the return. To us is the journey's end. So He is the one who begins the creation. He is the one who terminates. And He is the one who restarts. وَإِلَيْنَا الْمَصِيرُ. And if you think about it, if He gave life, if He caused death, you think everything is not going to return to Him? Of course. Of course it will. Everyone will. If He is the one who initiated, then all people will return to Him as well. يَوْمَ تَشَقَّقُ الْأَرْضُ عَنْهُمْ سِرَاعًا. When will they return? On the day the earth breaks away from them and they emerge rapidly. On the day of judgment, when تَشَقَّقُ الْأَرْضُ عَنْهُمْ. تَشَقَّقُ شِين قَافْ قَافْ شَقْ. And شَقْ is to split something apart, to break it apart, to rip it open, to tear it apart. So the earth will split apart عَنْهُمْ from them, meaning away from them. That the earth will open up, and as a result, the dead will emerge from their graves. يَوْمَ تَشَقَّقُ الْأَرْضُ عَنْهُمْ سِرَاعًا. Meaning that the earth will open, splitting open, tearing open from different places. And as it tears open, any person who is dead, buried underneath, he will emerge out, he will come out. It's not that people will have to dig themselves out of the graves, no. The earth will open up and they will come out of their graves. And how will they come out? سِرَاعًا, hastening, hurrying out. Sira' is a plural of sari', from the root letter sin ra'ain. And sari' is who? One who is in haste, meaning one who is doing something very quickly. So people will emerge out of their graves quickly. ذَلِكَ حَشْرٌ. That is a gathering. عَلَيْنَا, upon us. يَسِيرٌ, very easy. It's not difficult for Allah. If Allah can create the earth when the earth was nothing, He can bring the earth to an end as well. How? Splitting it open, so that the dead can come out. The dead can emerge out of their graves, sira'an, quickly. It's very simple for Allah. ذَلِكَ حَشْرٌ عَلَيْنَا يَسِيرٌ. Anas radiallahu anhu said that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَنَا أَوَّلُ مَن تَنْشَقُّ عَنْهُ الْأَرْضِ. The earth will open up first around me. He will be the first to emerge out of his grave. Allah says, نَحْنُ أَعْلَمُ بِمَا يَقُولُونَ. We are most knowing of what they say. The evidences are clear. The truth is obvious. And we know very well about what the people say to you in your denial. The objections they raise at the resurrection. The objections they raise at what you say to them. وَمَا أَنْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ بِجَبَّارٍ. And you are not over them a tyrant. Meaning you have not been sent over the people in order to force them to accept. You can only tell them. Isn't it so? Your duty is only to convey. You can only inform them. You cannot compel them. You cannot force them to accept. Your duty is just to convey. In Surah Ar-Ra'd, Ayah 40, فَإِنَّمَا عَلَيْكَ الْبَلَاغُ وَعَلَيْنَا الْحِسَابُ. Upon you is the duty to convey, and upon us is to call to account. Surah Al-Ghashiyah, Ayah 21-22, فَذَكِّرْ إِنَّمَا أَنْتَ مُذَكِّرْ. Remind, because you're only a reminder. لَسْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ بِمُسَيْطِرْ. You are not over them a controller. وَمَا أَنْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ بِجَبَّارْ. And how should you remind? Continue to remind. How? فَذَكِّرْ بِالْقُرْآنِ. So remind with the Qur'an. Continue to remind with the Qur'an. Even if they don't believe, even if they don't accept, continue. Keep reminding. Because there are some who will benefit. So فَذَكِّرْ بِالْقُرْآنِ مَنْ يَخَافُ وَعِيدٍ. One who fears my threat. Meaning keep reminding. And who will take that reminder? The one who fears my threat. He will benefit from that reminder. In Surah Yunus, Ayah 99, we learn, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala questions His Messenger, أَفَأَنْتَ تُكْرِهُ النَّاسَ حَتَّى يَكُونُوا مُؤْمِنِينَ. Then would you compel the people in order that they become believers? Can you compel them? You cannot compel them. You cannot force them. What can you do? You can only remind. And the one who fears Allah, the one who fears the warning of the hereafter, he will take benefit. Recitation.
وَكَمْ أَهْلَكْنَا قَبْلَهُمْ مِنْ قَرْنٍ هُمْ أَشَدُّ مِنْهُمْ بَطْشًا فَنَقَّبُوا فِي الْبِلَادِ هَلْ مِنْ مَحِيصٍ. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ ذِكْرَى لِمَنْ كَانَ لَهُ قلب أو ألقى السمع وهو شهيد. ولقد خلقنا السماوات والأرض وما بينهما في ستة أيام وما مسنا من لغوب. وما بينهما في ستة أيام وما مسنا من لغوب. فاصبر على ما يقولون وسبح بحمد ربك قبل طلوع الشمس وقبل الغروب. ومن الليل فسبحه وأدبار السجود. فاصبر على ما يقولون وسبح بحمد ربك قبل طلوع الشمس وقبل الغروب. ومن الليل فسبحه وأدبار السجود. واستمع يوم ينادي المناد من مكان قريب. يوم يسمعون الصيحة بالحق ذلك يوم الخروج. إنا نحن نحيي ونميت وإلينا المصير. يوم تشقق الأرض عنهم سراعا ذلك حشر علينا يسير. نحن أعلم بما يقولون وما وَعِيدٌ.
This ayah, وَاسْتَمِعْ يَوْمَ يُنَادِي الْمُنَادِي. And listen attentively on the day when the caller will call. مِمْ مَكَانٍ قَرِيبٍ. From a place that is very near. What does it show? Every person will hear the blowing of the trumpet. And it will be as though the sound is coming from very near. And it will have such an effect on every listener that those who are lying dead in their graves will come out alive. How? Sira'an. Hastening out of their graves, running out of their graves, no matter how deep down their graves are, no matter how their bodies are, all of them will emerge. ذَلِكَ حَشْرٌ عَلَيْنَا يَسِيرٌ. This is a gathering that is very easy upon Allah. Very easy for Him to collect everyone into one place. People that are scattered all over the earth, buried in different places. One is on the mountains, one is in the sea, one is deep underground, wherever their bodies are. ذَلِكَ حَشْرٌ عَلَيْنَا يَسِيرٌ. It's not difficult for Allah. Anything you'd like to say before we continue? Everybody stand up, please. What did you learn?
To busy ourselves with the dhikr and glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time. And if we were to do that and replace all the times that we talk so uselessly, we would end up benefiting so much from what we're doing, as opposed to just talking and, you know, wasting our time.
Yes, and many times when we're talking, what are we talking about? What we feel. Isn't it so? We're sharing our feelings with other people. So-and-so said this to me, so-and-so said that to me, this is how I feel so bad, I can't believe they did that, I can't believe they said that, I can't believe they think that. Isn't it so? This is what we're talking about. But such conversations, what do they bring? What do they bring to us? No satisfaction, no relief. Because no matter how much you talk about the situation, talking about it alone cannot solve it unless you talk to the person who is concerned, who needs to change. Can you change their heart? You can't. Can you force them to do something different? You can't. It's not in your control. Who can change their heart? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is why when you're distressed, when you're sad, when you're worried, busy yourself in doing the tasbih of Allah. Because He is the one who will give you comfort, and He is the one who can actually change the situation as well.
What we do, we go to our own friends or family and then we vent to them. So we say everything we wanted to say, but we say to our family. So not only is it a ghibah now, but you're not enduring patience at all in such a situation.
Exactly. And you see, this is a very common thinking that people have. If you do sabr, if you don't say anything, you're going to harm yourself, you're going to hurt yourself. And it happens sometimes that people keep taking the stress and it affects them physically even. Not just psychologically, but people get physically upset as well. Why? Because the sabr is not being done properly. Sabr is not just about controlling yourself. Sabr is, yes, you control yourself, but you expect help and relief from who? Allah. This is why you keep turning to Him.
Patience is possible, because many people do use the excuse that it's not within our control to endure that patience. Some people can and others cannot, and we have to vent and we have to let it out. So this ayah just proves that yes, it is possible, and that we need to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that when it's boiling within us,
yes,
seek His help.
Exactly. And keep turning to Him. If you think about it, so many times are mentioned over here. وَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ قَبْلَ طُلُوعِ الشَّمْسِ وَقَبْلَ الْغُرُوبِ وَمِنَ اللَّيْلِ. Is any time left? No. Throughout the day, throughout the night. And فَسَبِّحُ وَأَدْبَارَ السُّجُودِ. And also after the sujood. Also after you pray. Even then do tasbih. So if a person busies himself in the dhikr of Allah, in seeking His help, then definitely he will be at peace. No matter what difficulty he's going through. Because if you see, the Prophet ﷺ, the difficulty that he had to endure, it was great. If you think about how that difficulty has been described in the Qur'an, فَلَعَلَّكَ بَاخِعٌ نَفْسَكَ عَلَىٰ آثَارِ. You would almost kill yourself out of grief. You would almost die out of this grief. It was intense. It was a lot. But it's amazing how he survived. How? If you think about it, how? فَسَبِّحْ by tasbih, turning to Allah. And this is what we see in the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, that there is adhkar throughout the day and throughout the night. Isn't it so? Constantly he would engage in the dhikr of Allah, because that is what brings peace to the heart.
As-salamu alaykum. We always forget that, you know, when we're talking to each other, we see our family, we see our friends, we always forget that we're talking uselessly. There's a lot of things that we can talk about. We can do dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We can do da'wah. There's a lot of people who needs the truth to be known out there, and to busy yourself studying, learning about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that you are really going close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And these are the things that we should be doing instead of just talking. Like, you know, make sure that each time you open your mouth, it's beneficial to others and it's beneficial for you.
Because remember that hadith that if a person sits in a gathering and he doesn't remember Allah, it's as though he has been with who?
A dead donkey.
How disgusting. How disgusting. I mean, even if there is a donkey that is alive, many people don't even go near it. Why? It's dirty. It's smelly. Isn't it? There's too many flies. It can urinate any time. It's not really a good place to be in a barn with a donkey. But imagine a dead donkey, and we're perfectly fine with it. So we should be careful. Any conversation we're having, any place we're sitting in, people that we're with, whenever we talk, talk useful, talk beneficial, so that it's not the experience of a dead donkey that we're taking with us.
Assalamualaikum. I was just thinking the last ayah, فَذَكِرْ بِالْقُرْآنِ, the importance of knowing the Quran. Because sometimes what we do is that when we're trying to make da'wah or something like that, we go to science and then trying to bring the person to Islam, but the most effective is just to use the Quran.
فَذَكِرْ بِالْقُرْآنِ, and that's only possible when a person knows the Quran.
Assalamu alaikum. I was thinking about the ayah, فَصْبِرْ عَلَى مَا يَقُولُونَ, and then continue the ayah, وَاسْتَمِعْ يَوْمَ يُنَادِ الْمُنَادِ. SubhanAllah, like here about the salat, we're talking about all the five salat. So the munadi every day is calling us five times a day. And if we not respond that munadi, we're going to respond the other munadi, we like it or not. So we have to prepare for the big munadi.
فَاسْبِرْ عَلَى مَا يَقُولُونَ, this is only possible when a person ignores the mistakes of others. He disregards what the other people have said, if they're harsh words, mean words. Don't keep repeating them in your head. You know, we learned earlier that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows, وَنَعْلَمُ مَا تُوَسْوِسُ بِهِ نَفْسُ, that even what the soul whispers to us, the conversations that we have in our heads, even those Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows about. And many times, what do they revolve around? Can't believe she said that. And that entire conversation or that entire scene is replaying in our heads. Isn't it? So once we've forgiven someone, what does it mean? Don't keep thinking about it. Just ignore. Don't talk about it. Don't think about it. Because if you keep thinking about it, if you keep talking about it, you cannot forgive. You cannot get over it. Somebody was telling me that, you know, the month of Dhul Hijjah began and they were supposed to cut their nails and they weren't able to. They didn't get the chance. They were waiting until the last moment and they didn't get a chance. And now every time they see their nails, they get so, like, you can imagine how a person must feel. Nails are long, you want to cut them, but you can't cut them. And I told them, don't think about it, don't talk about it, don't look at your nails. It's difficult, very difficult, but don't look at your nails. And don't talk about it. Even if you think about it, don't talk about it. Don't say it to anyone. My nails are so long, I need to cut my nails, I need to cut my nails. No, don't even talk about it, because the more you talk about it, the more upset you'll become. Isn't it so? So similarly, when a bad experience has happened with someone, forgiving means don't repeat it in your head. Don't repeat it in your brain, because then you won't be able to let go. Recitation?
كان وهو شهيد ولقد خلقنا السماوات والأرض وما بينهما في ستة أيام وما مسنا من لغوب فاصبر على ما يقولون وسبح بحمد ربك قبل طلوع الشمس وقبل الغروب ومن الليل فسبح وأدبار السجود واستمع يوم ينادي المناد من مكان قريب يوم يسمعون الصيحة بالحق ذلك يوم الخروج إنا نحن نحيي ونميت وإلينا المصير يوم تشقق الأرض عنهم سراعا ذلك حشر علينا يسير نحن أعلم بما يقولون وما أنت عليهم بجبار فذكر بالقرآن من يخاف وعيد.
Let's listen to the recitation from the beginning.
سورة قاف. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
قاف والقرآن المجيد بل عجبوا أن جاءهم منذر.
نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.